the rules are going to be as simple, are going to be the same as always. I will continue to stream the game until something comes up where I have to stop, or my connection gives out on me. If my connection gives out on me, the stream will not continue. However, if that does not happen, the stream will continue. Look at the sand. That sand looks amazing. When this game came out in 2012, this and The Walking Dead from Telltale brought downloadable titles into the Games of the Year category. Not death downloadable titles, but Games of the Year, period. 2012 didn't really have a lot of good retail games that year, but the downloadable titles more than made up for it. Yeah, Abzu starts in a very similar way, by the way. So, anyways, it is time for me to start. This uses 6-axis. Of course, I don't have to use 6-axis. I can just... Hold on, let me see. I can just use my regular controller here. So, onward we go. You know, I almost feel like Abzu was a ripoff of this game. I mean, it's still a really good game, and it definitely has different elements to it than this one. But the basic story structure, and even down to the tutorial, is similar to this game. So I think this is 60 FPS, and I think it was 30 on PS3. So there's our destination. I have to go to this mountain. Seems simple enough, right? Well... it is, but it's... I wouldn't say it's difficult to get to the mountain, but it's definitely... there are a lot of sights to see getting there. Alright, so I guess we go exploring. Whee! Playing in the sand. So I wonder if these are people that have took the journey before me and died. Like, I wonder if these are tombstones that I'm seeing now. This game leads you by instinct and intuition. It really does. Cool, I could jump... it's been a while since I've played this. There's a lot of surprises that I don't remember. Okay. So basically, I'm going to get a scarf, and the more of those things I collect, the bigger my scarf gets, and the longer my scarf is, the farther I can jump and I can, you know, leap to farther distances with a longer scarf. There we go. And I can collect more of these, too. Now, there's one enemy that appears in the game. He can't kill you, but he can reduce your scarf. Like, he can take away the length of your scarf, really bring it down. So there is a little bit of a penalty, but not really, because you do gain your scarf back at the end. I'm basically spoiling this for those who haven't played it, but anybody who's into video games is interested in this game has played it by now, so... you know, this is a remaster, this isn't like a new game or anything like that, like Abzu is, you know. So I don't mind, you know, talking about things that happen later on in this game, since, well, if you haven't played it by now, well, shame on you, really. Okay, see if I can get up there. This thing's in the way. Because I need to get in there. I'd like to get in there. I can get this thing over here. There we go. Okay, I thought I saw something else. I think I have to wait for them to recharge or something. I don't know why. There we go. Got it. Let's see what else I can get. I wonder if I can get these to follow me. Then. Alright, well, I gotta find out where to go next. So let's continue to explore this area here. Okay. I gotta jump across. So I gotta climb this thing again. My bunny. Okay. I think I have opened this door. Boy, I gotta stand on this thing. There we go. It's been a while since I've played this. I haven't played this in years. I played it once all the way through. And I had to replay the ending because I went someplace I wasn't supposed to and got stuck. So I had to restart and play the snow sequence again. That was not fun. Story time! Yeah, but this game does a really good job of guiding you with very little instruction. No, it uses your intuition to guide you, and it's simple without being bogged down with explanation. All right, door is opening, and I get to go through. I will say this is probably my favorite score by Anton Wintory. Like, the score for this game is just absolutely epic. Alright, let's see what we can get here. You gotta go on those things and cross over. But there are things to see here, too. Alright, let's take a look around. Because there are things to activate. Ah, here's something. There we go. And we have a bridge now. And there's another one down there. I should activate that one as well. I'm gonna go head down there now and activate that. Oh, there's more. There's one there, one here. I know it sounds like I'm playing this for the first time, but no, I have played through this before. It's just been a while since I've played that. There we go. I might have used that one already, but I know this one is gonna do something. Okay, the path is clear now. So now I just gotta walk it. Hope I don't fall off the edge. I really like how the character glides through the sand. That's awesome. Okay, now there's some more stuff over here I'm gonna look at first. My bridge is ready for me, I just gotta cross it. Ah, there's something to get here. It always pays to walk around. You will get cool stuff. My scarf just got longer, too, than that, so... Anyway, I think I'm ready to head back now. Go ahead and cross this bridge. Look at me glide. Wonder if there's something else down there. Now they're gonna start hiding them better as the game goes on. You just know they're gonna do that. Alright, let's cross the bridge. Hope I don't fall! I could so easily fall off this thing. I'm seriously worried about falling off, guys. Luckily, this is pretty wide still. Stay centered. There we go. Kind of light these things up. That side is done. Alright, they're both done. Now I got a place to sit down. And there we go. That section is done. Time for more story. Audio's cutting up pretty bad here. Transportation. Need to see how they got around. All right, time to go in. Good, there's no gap there. That would suck if there was and I fell in it. On to the next part. Okay, the mountain looks closer, but it's still pretty far away from me. Wow. Someone else just got born. I think that's symbolic. I think you don't really see other players until you get here, and... That, the person who was just born from the volcano lets you know that I'm about to enter the multiplayer aspect of this game, which is pretty unique the way they set it up. Can't talk to each other except through musical notes, and it really makes things... By keeping a wall between us the way that it does, it actually bonds you closer in a very unique way. Oh, you get to free those things, too. Awesome. Yeah, this is a beautiful game. Anyways, let's see what's down here. Follow this thing. again, the sense of awe, like I talked about. You have this grand scope, you have cute little characters, and later on we're going to see some scary stuff too. So, yeah. And again, you just got to go to where the mountain is, unless you want to go off the beaten path and look for stuff. Let me follow my friend here. I think it will symbolize having a pet or something. There we go. Let's check this place out. Thanks for leading me here. I might have missed this place. There might be some more people to free here. Awesome! More creatures! That is fantastic. Alright, guys. Lead the way for me. Oh, he's helping give me a boost. Awesome. That was cool. Thank you very much. I'm just gonna follow you guys. Alright, let's see what's here. That was a hieroglyphic. Gave me some story and context. Let's go up here. More people are born. I wonder if this is happening in real time. I wonder if those are players actually starting the game. Oh, I gotta hit this place out. I wanna get that thing if I can. I'll be able to, but I can try. But I'm not gonna struggle on it too much. If I end up having a hard time, I'll just give up on it. I wanted to get it, but it's too hard. So, why struggle when you can just give up? That's my motto. Storm. Let's see what's over here. get up there. I give up here too, apparently. I can't jump anymore. Help me with the rest of this. Thank you. What is this? I don't remember this, honestly. Responding to my call here. I think someone just died in me. Oh. Alright, let's get up here. Saved them all. There was another bright thing too, but I couldn't get to it. There they go. Yay. Okay, so the level's not done? I mean, what else am I supposed to do? I think he's supposed to take me on. There we go. Thank you. They don't hand out trophies very, like, a lot, you know. By the truckloads. Thank you very much. I think we're going on a ride here. Yep. I'm gonna go to these things. Yeah, I remember this part. This part I do remember, for sure. Okay, there's no way I'm getting that thing. Let's get to this thing here. That is too hard to get, so. Alright, there's probably some more things I gotta do here. You can't even jump unless you've got, unless you're like powered up. Yep, there's something over here. Too hard. I'm not even sure I can get up there. There we go. Thank you, guys. Wow, look at the golden, this is like a golden shower right here. Look at the way the sun reflects on the sand. That is beautiful right there. That is a screenshot right there. Dark abyss we go. See what they can. Let's look around here for a little bit. We're about to enter the dark parts of this game. And when this segment, on the next segment, I'm gonna pause so I can use the bathroom, take my nose spray, and my schedule. So, after this cutscene's done. This game actually takes a little bit of skill. Because, in order to get certain places, you need to be able to leap farther in the air, and you do that by connecting to the little floating carpets that you see flying around. They're basically fuel to keep you flying. Alright, let's go in here. And we're about to meet the only enemy in the game. And he can't really kill you, he just takes away your scarf. So you can't fly much. Trying to pause this thing. You pause by meditating. You don't really pause. The game doesn't pause. You just end up sitting down. Very dangerous place to sit down if you think about it. Anyway, I will be taking my, I got something to take care of. I'll be right back. So hold on a second, alright? Alright, I'm back. Anyways, let's continue this journey. Okay, I really don't want to be in the light here. I don't even see the enemy yet. Cool. There's something in here. That one was easy to get. There are parts in this game that make me think I'm underwater. Like this here. I feel like I'm underwater here. There's definitely a watery sensation to this part of the game. Thank you very much for getting me through that. Yeah, that part definitely felt like I was underwater. I might be underwater, I don't know. But that felt very watery. Like, very oceany. Bet my enemy's here. They are really good at making you feel like you're in danger, even though you're not really. Like, these people should make a horror game where you can't die. If anyone can make a horror game where you can't die, it should be people who worked on this and on Abzu, because they're able to really create a sense of dread without actually putting your character in danger. Whoa, he's got a light, too. Whoa, crap, that was an enemy. I thought it was a place to hide. Check this out. Tell me that is not scary. There's more than one. I only remember there being one. Oh crap, it's got me. Did I make it? I think I did. I think I just made it. Because I still have some scarf left, and I didn't have that much to begin with, but I didn't. I still have a scarf. I don't know if I made it or not, honestly. Because those things can't kill you, they just take your scarf away. But they can create real suspense, even without actually killing your character. That's not easy to do. Platforming coming up. I haven't met another player yet. I figured there'd be more people playing this game since it's free now. Alright, here we go. Trophy, my first trophy for this game. Or at least for the PS4 version. I didn't have to figure it out last time because I was playing with somebody and they pretty much did a little work for me to just follow them. Okay. I'm gonna need some help with this. Because I have to climb up. I gotta jump up. I'm all by myself this time. So.